You know, how did you feel about Gil passing? You had some tough last years. How did you feel about all of that? Were you really in contact very much?
We had kind of lost contact over the last maybe 3 or 4 years. Over the last 3 or 4 years, it's, you know, it gets to a point when in some friendships where you can't really talk. And you don't have to make a decision whether you're just going to keep, rehashing the same things over and over again, or whether you're going to move on. And so I got to the point where I figured it's really time to move on. And, you know, the Gil that I was talking to then wasn't even the same Gil that I knew. So I don't know how much he actually regretted it, and, you know, I think I regretted it a lot, you know. But there wasn't anything I could do about it. And one of the most important things in life to learn is how to let go. So when people ask me, how did I feel about his going, his passing, I always say that I'd let him go. I had to let him go a long time ago. So his physical removal from the planet was just the last of a, was the most tangible manifestation of his leaving. You know, and of course I was saddened by it. You know, I was saddened every time I felt that another part of him left.
You've worked together for such a long time, did so much music together.
Yeah. And whenever we, even up until the last time we performed together, whenever we performed together, it was always magic. There was something that was very magical about our collaborating together and our working together and writing together. That nothing could change. Nothing could change. The only thing that changed was the level of difficulty in being able to do that, to get together to do that.
Those are some legendary albums. Those are albums that will be around pretty much forever, I think.
Who knew? Yeah. Who knew? I mean, we never thought that we would be considered those, like, the same kind of artist as those who we revered. You know, and now people look at us now.